Hello, this is Senator Randi Becker from the 2nd District, welcoming you to my electronic newsletter. I am so tickled that we actually have the ability to put this newsletter out weekly, because I think it's so important that you get to know what's happening down here in Olympia. You know, the budget has been the big talk of this session, and actually for the prior two sessions as well. So today I wanted to talk a little bit about how the budget comes together and how certain things are included in the budget, and you know, just give you an idea of how the system works a little more down here. So as you know, people put in a bill. Those bills are assigned to committees. So for example, if you have a bill dealing with agricultural issues, it would be heard in the agricultural committee. If you have bills being heard on health care, it would be heard in the health care committee. And what happens then is, on the original bill, most of the time there's a fiscal note asked for. And what the fiscal note does is it determines how much money that bill, if it's passed, would actually cost the state of Washington or save the state of Washington. So any bill that is passed out of a committee that has a fiscal note attached to it is then referred to what's called Ways and Means. Now, Ways and Means is the committee that reviews every bill with this fiscal note, and they decide if this is something that is worthwhile to pass, that the state should bear the cost of this or bear the savings of this. And that's where that will be decided if it passes out of committees. So I think the most important thing is that every bill that has a fiscal note attached needs to be really considered. We need to make sure that the value of that fiscal note outweighs the cost. And I really believe that that is something that is a most important part of the budget process this year. So now I'd like to talk a little bit about how the actual budget comes together. It's kind of like putting puzzle pieces together. Basically, the governor has written a proposed budget. And there's a whole bill, it's probably over 500 pages, that talks about the governor's budget. But what she has done is she has identified areas from her perspective that need to either be cut, added, changed, whatever her methodology may be. And it'll say the language, and then there'll be a space, and it'll fill in a bill number. And that's what we have to wait and see what each of those bills actually does. We can review the entire language, but all of that language may totally be changed and affected by each one of those bills. So again, while it's a puzzle piece that's extremely important that we pay attention to all of the details and have the time to read every detail so that we can make a decision that we think that our constituents would want us to do. Now, this leads into what I believe is a problem in the process. If we look at how the budget process has occurred in the last 2 years that I've been here, it really tends to move very, very quickly, actually too quickly. And last year, that entire 515-page bill that I just talked about, how that all fits together, was introduced and passed on the Senate floor within a 48-hour period. So, as you know, or you may not know, I introduced a bill this year that allowed a 24-hour notice on any bill that would require legislation dealing with taxes, spending, and budgeting to be available for at least 24 hours before a committee hearing, a committee vote, or a final consideration of the Senate or the House of Representatives. The reason I wanted to do that, as you can see, this budget is extremely detailed. And I felt that we needed to have at least 24 hours to assimilate it, make decisions, ask questions, and do, again, what you've asked us to do. Well, I found out this week that 24-hour legislation intended to really create that transparency we've all been talking about is not going to move forward at this time. Now, we have until Tuesday. But if it hasn't passed by Tuesday out of committee, then I can tell you I'm extremely disappointed, to say the least. Again, I'm just telling you how important I feel that transparency is, and it shouldn't be, a partisan issue. There's no sides to this matter. It is a matter of everybody having the ability to do what they need to do in order to make their decisions. So I may sound a little down about that, but I really, really feel that it was so important to me that we be able to start to rebuild some of the trust that the people have lost because of the loss of transparency. And so we'll move forward and we'll keep pushing on another bill next year, and hopefully we'll come up with some resolve on this. What I would really like to do is, if you feel strongly about this 24-hour bill, go in and take a look at what it says. If you feel strongly enough, write to your local newspapers, write letters to the editors, write to the senators down here, and see if you can get them to consider hearing it again. We just have a short period of time, but it would be greatly appreciated. Well, that's the end of this electronic newsletter audio update. But I want to give you my weekly sales pitch. As you know, I'm probably getting to be known for that. I would like you to make sure that you tell your friends, your neighbors, and anybody that might be interested in what's happening down here in Olympia to sign up for our electronic newsletters. It's important that people know about it. Again, I try to just tell you the facts. We will have more information available to you as time goes on. I hope everybody has a good week, and thank you for watching these.